How to use Bybit sub-account full tutorial. In most cases, people open sub-account because they have different strategies that they would like to use, for example, on a spot and a futures that I advise. And second reason, when you would like to give your money under management to someone. We also working with our investors through sub-accounts. In both cases, you need it and how to start. First, of course, you open account on Bybit. If you already have it, what you do, open this guy and here would be a sub-account menu. Maybe in the future, placement of that menu would change. You need to understand. After that, at this moment, as you can see, it is a list of sub accounts that I have, because what I do, I open accounts, and for some of my students I give money under management and educate them, work with them to help them improve their approach and become profitable. As I shared with you, there are two reasons why people in most cases open it. Once more, if you open it for yourself, you just use standard sub-account. Because here, as you can see, you can switch this account without even entering a password. Because why would you need a password if it is your account and only you have access? Once more, if you create account for other people that would work for you, use a custodial trading sub-account. Let's open both of them to show you how things go on. Here, let's do standard sub-account. Let's name it Bico Trading. Here, require password to log in. Honestly, you don't need it, because in the end you will need to access into your major account. If you have nothing to hide, don't use it. If you would like to hide it, add additional password. I don't use it. Confirm. At this moment, as you can see, it require verification from email and Google. Let's add it. Okay, we just created that account. What we do? First operation, when you press switch, you will switch to that account, because at this moment I log in into my main account and you can press switch. And at this moment, as you can see, we are inside of that sub-account. I name it Bico Trading, and it has unique UID, but that ID is only inside in Bybit. In general, Bybit will see you as that one UID. Additionally, for login, withdraw, and anything else, you can add also a Google two-factor authentication also for this sub-account. Let's add it. At this moment, I think so simple, you go and open your Google authentication, you scan it, and you enter that code, and congrats, you have this Google authentication. Highly advise you to use it. Also, to disable, you can disable, but we won't do it. Next, really important questions that many people would ask when you use sub-account, you will have questions how to fund it. As you can see here, funding account. At this moment, let's add money into our sub account. Before, my friends, I highly advise you to join our public Telegram, because nearly on daily basis we share free signals, market updates, useful lessons that will help you understand the market and make money. At this moment, you can join right now for free while it's possible. Link is in description. How to fund that account? As you can see here, it is a transfer. First, to transfer, what you do, you choose from which account you send it. As you can see, at this moment, it is your main account, and after that, you choose, for example, your spot or your derivatives, depends where you have money. And for example, you can choose to send, for example, $5. After that, as you can see, you choose what type of sub-account, as you can see, Bico Trading, and into funding account. And let's send $5. We don't need Bico to show you an example. At this moment, you can see it shows you how much money you have on that account. You can press here details and can show you in BTC how much exactly you have. And again, here you do settings. What you can do, you can, once enabled, you'll be able to switch between your main account and sub account directly by clicking a switch. I advise you to do from your main computer. When you do freeze sub account, could be in a situation when your manager, you give money to someone to manage it, and you want to stop their trading activities because they did some mistake, or you don't trust them, or you stop cooperation. It's so simple, you just press this once, freeze account. I assure logging and RP management using this sub account will no longer be supported when you freeze it. It would stop trading. Okay, let's switch. Also, when you work with sub account, sometimes you will use statistic service, you will connect it to other application. For example, when I analyze data in ATAS, I also connect my accounts to ATAS, and here it would be RP management. And remember that on each sub account you work nearly at this same account. After that, how you can go back to your main account? Again, you here this guy, and here you can see your main account, or here you can choose account switch. and you can do your main account. And at this moment I am in a main account. And again, here you can go to this sub-account menu. Again, as I shared with you, you can create a custodial trading account. It is Bicker Trading Management. Too much. Unified trading account, confirm. And again, you will need confirmation by email, two-factor confirmation, and you'll be able to share your login in and password, your username, as you can see. When you work with this, you'll be able to share info with people that work for you, because for each account, as you can see, you can log in into user sub-account login. I will add this link into description to this video, because people who work with sub-accounts, they will have separate logins than on your main account. And to log in into each of your sub accounts, you will need here in the settings, as you can see here, login management. Here you can see create a password. What you do, you press create a password and you decide Bicker la 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 la. In all that cases, that password must confirm. You'll share your username that you have here, password that you have, and also you can get access to Google Authenticator to people that work for you. Remember that on all the sub-accounts, you cannot withdraw money on that sub-account. If you switch to a sub-account, here you won't even find a button. Let's do assets. As you can see, we sent our $5, and only one thing that we can do here, it is to put those money into earn, transfer between our sub-accounts, and that's it. You can't do anything else on this account. That's a beautiful one. My friend, remind to you that exchange is a part of this business. You need to know where to buy, where to sell. That's the reason why I share with you my secret approach, how to make money on the crypto market while it rise, drop. Watch it right now until I close it to a public.